Hello everybody, it's been a few days since I've done a video, not that long, but anyways, E3 is officially over. So how was it? Well, it was pretty most excellent, but the last couple days, because E3 is supposed to be 4 days, the 9th, the 10th, the 11th, and the 12th. Now, I have some papers here. Right here. See these? Papers. Okay? There's the order. So, I'm gonna say some cool stuff that was at E3 and some cool stuff that, some stuff I didn't give a shit about. So I have them separated into different categories. Not by any means does this mean that's bad, but it just means that if it's in a category of I don't really care about it, it means it hasn't caught my attention, or I just really don't give a shit about it. So, here we go. The Xbox conference, they were the first ones to go. So, I have an excited category. Fuck yes, which is what I'm excited for. And a don't care. So in the excited category, we have a new Call of Duty. Now you might be saying, ugh, but I thought you hated Call of Duty. But I did make a trailer saying, or a video to the trailer saying, the new Call of Duty actually does seem rather interesting. Intriguing? Yes. So, it shows some gameplay, and it shows some boots that can boost you. Kind of like jet boots, but they can also reduce fall damage, or prevent it. So, it did look impressive. There was evolved gameplay. It looked very, very pretty, and it looked very solid and very smooth. We got Dragon Age Inquisition. The gameplay didn't really wow me, but it looked really, possibly like it has potential. So then we got Fable Legends. Now the characters will talk to each other, and they will say, like, you know, quirky things to each other and stuff, but there's also a strategy element to where you can do strategy stuff. Kind of like an MMO World of Warcraft type deal, I guess. Project Spark, it does look impressive, but then they did a cock tease about Conker saying, oh, if you want to see Conker, you can make him in your own game. And it's like, fuck you, Microsoft. Fucking queers. Anyways. Inside, this is the game to... from the studios who did Limbo. I believe they're called Play Dead Studios. Excuse my eyes are just bothering me right now. So it looks great. It shows your guy in a more diverse environment. You can swim. It shows him walking up to glass with all these people just looking out hopelessly. It looks very, 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 very great. Might be longer than Limbo, I'm not sure. But that is an exclusive to the Xbox One. Phantom Dust, they are rebooting it. The trailer looked great, and then you see... wait, I think this is just a fighting game. Maybe I'm wrong. I don't know, but that's what I'm guessing. Now... I'm going to save the fuck yes for the end, for the last part. Don't care. Alright, just got one yawn out of my system because I've had a long day. Forza 5, no, excuse me, not Forza 5, Forza Horizon 2, don't give a fuck about. It looks great, but don't care. Assassin's Creed Unity, don't give a fuck about. I mean, there was some stuff that looked pretty potentially cool, but eh. Dance Central Spotlight. It's where you use your smartphone or some shit like that as the controller. Ori. It's an indie game. Just what I saw of it didn't catch my eye, but I do like indie games. Halo Master Chief Collection. It's got all the greatest moments of Master Chief. So, that could be good. Halo Anniversary 2. That's cool. Halo Nightfall. So, basically, when you get the Master Chief Collection, you'll get Halo Nightfall and a Halo 5 beta that comes later on this year. Night Squad. That's another one. Now, for the fuck yes, we got Sunset Overdrive. It was great. It was showing a thing of Call of Duty, kind of making, poking fun at it. And this dude is like all badass. The gameplay, you would see guys die and would explode with like blam, like in their blood or whatever. It's got fourth wall breaking, which is great. And it's got a lot of comedy, and it is from Insomniac. It looks fucking fantastic, and I'm jealous of Xbox One owners till I get one. Dead Rising 3, super awesome. Costumes, they got, it's called Dead Rising, Super Ultra Hyper Mega Alpha Omega 2 something, something crazy title. But you can play as Ryu, you can play as Chun-Li, you can play Dead Rising characters as a rival school's character, Falcon from Power Stone, you can play as Tofu. I mean, there's tons of different things. I'm not sure exactly how many outfits, but it looks great. There's one called Azlez. This is the guy's... Wait. Aztez. That's an indie game. It looks great. I don't remember. You can look it up. White Knight. Another one that looks great. Cuphead. It looks like an actual cartoon. It looks potentially great. Lifeless Planet, that's another one that looks really cool. Rise of the Tomb Raider, now this was exciting. This is not an Xbox One exclusive, this is just shown at the conference. So, you see that, and it shows Lara, she's like mentally damaged, and she's from a psychiatrist and a therapist, and he's asking, hey, you know, you should get out sometime, try going some places, and you see a couple bit of gameplay. But she's really messed up, she's shaking and stuff like that. And the plot of it is something about her knowing something, and this group called the Shadow Organization is trying to get go after her. So it's got like an Illuminati type of vibe, and it sounds fucking glorious. Witcher 3, it looked fucking beautiful. The text, the draw distance was fucking amazing. The Xbox and the EA conference I got to watch with my great buddies, Gypsy Fruitcakes. Gypsy, you're a motherfucker, and I love you. And Crane Zane is the creator of the universe for any of the new gen consoles, for anything, for the oxygen, for Einsteinium, and all the elements and everything that is a part of this earth, you can thank Crane for, because he created you. Anyways, also, this guy, Stan the Man, Pakistan, with the iron hand, with the plan, met him in a chat room, he's a really cool-ass dude, Stan the Man, or Stan the Salesman, is the Monkey Island guy, and he's fucking amazing. But Stan is awesome, so we got to watch all this together, and we got to see some awesome shit. And Witcher 3, it looks great, draw distance looks great. The fighting looks phenomenal. Geralt looks great. Horse riding, it just looks fucking beautiful. And it looks fantastic. Then we have The Division. It shows gameplay. The voice acting is like one of the best I've ever heard in my life. It is so fucking great. It makes me wonder, are those real people talking? I don't know. But it is... Wow. Anyways, okay. So that's the Xbox conference. Now, we got EA. EA hardly had anything. I got... Awesome, oh my god, yes, and I don't care. So for the awesome, we got Dragon Age Inquisition. Yeah, there was a little bit more shown, and it looked okay. The I don't care Sims 4. Sims 4 got announced, and you can do weird stories or some shit. Cool. UFC. You got Bruce Lee. That's awesome. NHL. Whatever. Don't give a fuck. PGA Tour. Don't care. Madden 15. Don't care. FIFA 15. Again. Don't give a fuck. And Mass Effect 4. There was some little bit shown, and it looked like it could potentially be great, but there was hardly anything shown. Now, you have a Mystery Criterion game, which is like an extreme sports type of deal. You see a dude jump out of a copter onto a fucking ATV. You see a guy on a boat go off a waterfall and then parachute or some shit. It looks like it could potentially be amazing, so we'll see. Mirror's Edge 2, there's a little bit more gameplay. Not really. There was like more of a making of type of deal. It looks potentially great. Battlefront, they showed them actually going to the real locations in the movies and getting the actual place, but also the feelings and emotions behind that place. So Battlefront looks like it's coming along great, and I can't wait to see some actual gameplay. They do show, I think, a tiny bit of like in-game stuff, but not like actual real-time gameplay. Now, that was EA. So it was mostly crap, but except for some of the stuff I'd mentioned. Far Cry 4, it looks great. Pagan Min, he looks fantastic. Later on, you'll see more in Sony's conference, but I'll get to that. So he's talking and he seems very fucked up, and I love his personality. He's a really cool guy. Seems really like he could be a great villain, anti-hero, whatnot. Then Rainbow Six Siege. Now, Rainbow Six Patriots got canceled to make Rainbow Six Siege. Siege is there's a hostage situation in the home, and you put these bombs on walls and stuff, and it looks like it could be great. This was in a multiplayer, so it looks like it could be great, but Rainbow Six Patriots, I'm really bummed about, because I've been following that game for a damn last long time. Valiant Hearts is an indie game. The Crew, they showed some on The Crew. It looks cool, but I might play it, you know, I just don't really care about news about it. Assassin's Creed Unity, more about that. I don't give a fuck. I believe it's co-op in the story, so that's new. Now, we got PS4. We got some awesome shit right here. We got Destiny. The gameplay looked really good. But I don't know, it's got a Halo vibe, so meh. The Order, they showed real Order footage. It looks incredibly, fantastically, just astounding. Second Son DLC, The First Light, I believe it's called. You can play as Fetch, so that's interesting. So it'll probably be different powers. Little Big Planet 3 looks adorable. You've got like a bird character that can carry your little sack boy and stuff, and it's just fucking great. It looks so fucking adorable, and it just looks awesome. And I played a bit of Big Planet 1 and a little bit of 2, but 3 I'm definitely pumped about. Bloodborne. It is From Software. So the guys who did Dark Souls and stuff. So is this a Souls game? We're not exactly sure, but what we saw looks great. Far Cry 4 gameplay shows an elephant tipping over a bus. And it explodes and stuff. It looks great. And you're on a mountainside, and it looks beautiful. Now, if you have a PlayStation TV, you can play with friends, even if they don't own the game. That's interesting. Entwined. It's where two souls are of different colors that they can't be together, but they entwine in real life or something like that. Seems interesting, but just not the explanation of it. I might still play it, but just it didn't catch my attention. Let's see. Now we got two categories. Awesome and I don't care. Magicka 2. Sorry, I don't really care about that. Devolver, an indie title. Vanstar, I'm not exactly sure what I fucking wrote. Then we got Dead Island 2. It starts off with the song. This guy's putting on headphones, starts jogging. Where is he? Where the fuck is he? He's on Venice Beach! Oh my fucking god! And you see all this shit going on behind him. And it's got the song, I'm a bomb, I'm about to blow up. I'm a bomb, I'm about to blow up. Now, where do we hear that song from? Tony Hawk Pro Skater HD. That's right. And I believe I hated that song and I was annoyed by fuck by it. So yeah. And at the very end, it shows a bunch of dudes come pull forward and stuff like that in a hippie van. And they, voices sounded like Aaron Paul and Jack Black. But in the order, it was Jack Black and then Aaron Paul. Is this actually them? I do not know, but we shall fucking see soon enough. But there is some new Dead Island 2 news, and here's something. You can now dual wield. Now you can wield a machete and a shotgun. This is actual news from the developer himself. Jaeger is actually developing Dead Island 2, the guys who made Spec Ops The Line. Now, there was a developer interview, and it sounded fantastic. Also, it's got, like, environmental deaths and stuff like that. It just sounds fantastic. It's supposed to release in the spring. Spring is going to be busy. So there is also a you're going to be able to live stream your game footage to YouTube. Oh my god. So you can do, everyone can do Let's Plays now, I guess. And Double Fine, Tim Schafer bringing back a motherfucking classic, Grim Fandango. So that's great. Maybe we'll see Maniac Mansion, Day of the Tentacle, maybe Santa Max hit the road later on. We also have some indie titles. We got Not a Hero. We got Hotline Miami 2, which looks fucking great. We got The Talos Principle, which looks potentially could be amazing. Broforce, which that's very exciting. Then yes, we have more. So then we got Fuck Yes and I Don't Care, free-to-play games, bunch of free-to-play games. PS Now can play on Sony TVs and later on PS3 and Vita. A PlayStation TV is $99. That was, they changed the name of what it was called before, something. There's a show called Powers that's made, that's Marvel, and that will be interesting. Let It Die, we got a new Suda 51 game that is unfortunately found out to be free to play, but I really hope to fuck that it's great, because I love Suda 51. I've loved every single game from Suda 51, from Killer 7 to Shadows of the Damned, Lollipop Chainsaw, and Killer is Dead. So what else do we got? We got a game called Abzu. Now Abzu is from the makers of Journey. It looks beautiful. It looks really mystical. It's got an underwater theme, and it looks wonderful. Ab and zoo is two things. Like, one means water, and one means something else. There was new No Man's Sky footage, like actual footage. It showed like a T-Rex and stuff, and you find these new species, and then you get in a ship and go somewhere else. It looks fucking phenomenal. Beautiful as hell. Mortal Kombat 10, more footage. The fatalities are great. There shows a dude where he puts a hole through this dude's chest, and then he grabs the guy's spine and just and then just really fucking right close there. And then you see, like, someone slams a dude's fucking face into the ground, and you see the skull just it looks fucking amazing. It looks wonderful. There's going to be a Ratchet and Clank movie. It looks great. I'm not very familiar with Ratchet and Clank, but I will be. There's also a Ratchet and Clank remake, so I don't really know much about that, but that could be great. Last of Us remake, they didn't show actual footage, but they actually confirmed it, so new Phantom Pain trailer looked great. There was kind of some stuff that was like, whoa, that's brutal. Just one spoiler alert that showed, I believe, what was his cremated comrades, like, rubbing his face with it. And that was kind of, whoa, that's a little whoa. GTA 5 is coming to the PS4 and PC, finally! Are you fucking happy? Am I happy? Maybe. For PC? Yes, I cannot wait to see what all you motherfuckers are going to do with mods. There's new Arkham Knight gameplay. It shows the actual Batmobile, and it looks great. There's an Uncharted 4 teaser, and this just in, they announced that they're trying to make the trailer, the gameplay, better than the trailer, which is like, what? So they're basically trying to outdo themselves. Now, Nintendo. This was day two. Day two, we got Smash Brothers. Every stage has a final destination. You've got Master Balls for legendary Pokemon. You have custom move sets. Smash Run, that's only on 3DS. Sonic Boom gameplay, it actually looks pretty cool. Hyrule Warriors gameplay, that looked actually impressive, and I'm not a huge Dynasty Warriors fan. Xenoblade Chronicles X, yes, this is what the game X was called. You see, I think a little bit of gameplay, but the trailer looks impressive. Mario Maker for the Wii U. You can create your own Mario levels with 3D Mario or old school Mario. It looks fucking brilliant. Splatoon. This is a paintball game, a multiplayer game, where you can shoot. You gotta, I guess, cover up more pieces of the area with your color. But in your color, you can also dive in, and you can, wherever your color is, if it's connected, you can go and, like, be an underwater creature or something. So, it's very unique, and I'm very impressed. So, we also have, for the I don't care, we have Amiibo, which is like Skylanders. I'm like, okay, that's kind of cool, but they can also get experience. You can do them in Smash Bros. They're going to put it in Mario Kart 8, I guess. Captain Toad's Treasure Tracker, it looks like it could be cool. Bayonetta 2, there was a new Bayonetta 2 trailer, but it includes Bayonetta 1, which also includes Nintendo outfits and maybe moves. It didn't exactly make that clear to me. Kirby and the Rainbow Curse, you draw stuff with the stylus or the pen or whatever, and it does it. Kirby goes and stuff. Mario Party 10, whatever. I just want a Mario Party original on my 3DS. Now, we got Devil's Third. Wait, didn't I say Nintendo? Yes, I did. Guess what? Wii U got Devil's Third. It looks great. It shows a dude chucking a fucking katana into a dude's face, and then you're chopping up dudes, and it just looks fucking brutal. And Wii U is really fucking, wow, they're doing a great fucking job. Phoenix Wright vs. Ace Attorney. That is a 3DS game, and that looks great. There's also supposedly a Phoenix Wright trilogy, so that could potentially be great. We got 3DS Pokemon Art Academy, because you can learn to draw Pokemon. 3DS Theater Rhythm Curtain Call. Now, Curtain Call is the sequel to Theater Rhythm, but this one also has, like, live-action fighting things, so it's got, like, lightning, and it's got, like, cloud in a fight scene and stuff, and it looks like it could be great. There's a game called, there's a theater game for eShop called the, that's a breakout type of game. Looks like it could be okay. Yoshi's Woolly World. This is like Kirby's epic yarn, but this is Yoshi's Woolly World. Everything's made of wool, but Yoshi's a 3D model, so it looks really great. Fantasy Life for 3DS. Mario vs. Donkey Kong Wii U, I was thinking it was like a remake of the classic one. Art Academy for the Wii U. Shantae Pirate's Curse, that's an eShop title. Now we got a couple more Nintendo... No, we got other very other couple things. Final Fantasy Type-O, PS4 and the Xbox One. There was a Doom 4 teaser, but the actual real Doom 4 stuff, or whatever the fuck they're going to call the Doom, will be at QuakeCon, so we gotta wait. Dragon Ball Z Xenoverse. Supposedly it's got destructible environments and stuff like that. It sounds like it could be great. Alien Isolation trailer. There wasn't much, but it did seem pretty intense, but the trailer was kind of it didn't. And then, guess what's coming to PS4? More indie games, but some of the ones that we love. Surgeon Simulator! Yes, Surgeon Simulator is coming to the PS4. And Loadout is also coming to PS4. And there was a trailer for Everybody's Gone to the Rapture. And there was some some Destiny gameplay and some stuff like that. But Day 3, there was a new Zelda trailer for Wii U, and it looks fucking great. It looks beautiful. It looks like paintbrush, waterbrush style graphics. It's just wow. It is gorgeous. A couple other characters. Pac-Man is going to become the Smash Brothers, and Pelutena. That's all we know for Smash Brothers right now, and no Resident Evil 7. No other thing from Deep Silver, because Jaeger is doing Dead Island 2. Nothing from Nordic Games. No Last Guardian. No, we didn't see Kingdom Hearts 3. No, we didn't see Final Fantasy 15. No, we didn't see Dishonored 2. No, we didn't see Sleeping Dogs 2. No, we didn't see Getaway 3. No, we didn't see the title from Sony Bend. We didn't see the title from Sony London. And we did not see the game from Guerrilla Games. So, was E3 a disappointment? The last half was. Seeing the Zelda game, that was cool. That was nice. Yeah, but, other than that, the last couple days just really pissed me off. I mean, seeing Everybody's Gone to the Rapture trailer was cool, and it looks fucking gorgeous, but hoping I'm gonna get a full chockload of fucking awesome info, and it's like, oh, Dino Crisis, and but no, I didn't. The last 2 days, day 3 and day 4, were super lacking, and that pissed me off. I'm really bummed out about that, but day 1 and day 2 were fucking wonderful as fuck. So that is E3 2014. So any other big game news? Hopefully we'll get something soon. And we got QuakeCon and GamesCon, and then, or GamesCom, I believe it's called, and Tokyo Game Show. So Resident Evil 7, Onimusha Remake, Dino Crisis, are we going to get Rival Schools? Are we going to get Project Justice? Are we going to get Power Stone again? What's up with Darkness? We're going to get another Darkness, right? Condemned? Yes? Please? Please? We'll see. We will see. Only, we didn't think a Grim Fandango thing was going to come, so classics can be brought back from the dead. So, that is it. That is the entirety of E3. What did you guys get excited about? I don't know. I told you what I was excited about, and I still have fuckloads of games to beat. But I'm gonna go try to work on some of them, and that is E3. And yes, I just wish that it stretched out and it was longer, or just there was more shit on day 3 and 4, but there wasn't. So, c'est la vie. You guys get pumped for the awesome shit to come!